In the equilibrium lab, we'll be using the concentrations of thiocyanate and iron 3 plus ions to find the equilibrium constant of the reaction shown below. We need sodium thiocyanate and iron 3 chloride hexahydrate, an electronic scale, 2 50 mL volumetric flask, 2 10 mL graduated cylinders, 1 100 mL graduated cylinder, 2 100 mL beakers, 1 200 mL beaker, 3 pipette, 5 test tubes, and a test strip rack. First, zero off the weight boat. Then, measure approximately 0.5 grams of iron 3 chloride hexahydrate, record the weight you measure out. Pour the iron 3 chloride hexahydrate into the 100 mL beaker and add a little water. Swirl the solution to dissolve the solids. Carefully pour the solution into the 50 mL volumetric flask. Add water using a dropper until the solution reaches a white line on the volumetric flask. For the second solution, measure out about 0.25 grams of sodium thiocyanate and repeat the process using the second beaker, volumetric flask, and pipette. In order to calibrate the spectrophotometer, we need to set the wavelength to 450 by turning the knob on the top. Make sure the mode is on transmittance. Make sure the sample holder is empty. Adjust the transmittance to 0 by adjusting the 0% T knob on the bottom left. The knobs are very sensitive, so slight adjustments will work. Fill a test tube with water and put it into the sample holder. Make sure the white label on the test tube faces you when you put the test tube in. When the reading remains stable, adjust the transmittance to 100 by adjusting the 100% T knob on the bottom right. Then take the test tube and close the sample holder and see if the transmittance goes back to 0. If it doesn't, recalibrate it. Then put a test tube back in. If the transmittance doesn't go back to 100, recalibrate it using the 100% T knob. After the calibration is finished, set the mode to absorbance. In order to prepare the solution for trial 1, measure out 1 mL of the sodium thiocyanate solution. And 1 mL of iron 3 chloride solution. Measure out 98 mL of water in a 100 mL graduated cylinder and pour it into the giant beaker. Add the sodium thiocyanate solution and iron 3 chloride solution into the water. Swirl the solution and pour it into the first test tube so it's about 3/4 full. Dispose of the rest in the sink. Repeat the process for the remaining 3 trials. Make sure you wash the large beaker every time as you prepare a new solution to avoid cross-contamination. The amount of solutions used for each trial is listed on the screen. Take out the water test tube from the sample holder. Close the holder and the absorbance should go back to 1.999. To test the absorbance of the first sample, place the test tube with the white label towards you into the holder. Wait for the reading to stay constant and record the number. Repeat the process for the remaining 3 test tubes. In part 2 of this lab, we explore the effects of different solutions on the equilibrium listed. There are 5 trials, with one of the trials being the control. Make sure to record any color change. First, make the solution from trial 3 again, which requires 3 mL of sodium thiocyanate and 3 mL of iron 3 chloride, and 94 mL of water. Then distribute the solution into 5 test tubes, filling each about 1/2 to 3/4 full. For trial 1, add 1 mL of FeCl3 solution to the second test tube and record a color change. Swirl the test tube to mix. For trial 2, add 1 mL of NaSCN solution to the third test tube and record color change. Swirl the test tube to mix. For trial 3, add 1 ml of Na2 HPO4 solution to the 4th test tube. And for trial 4, add 1 ml of KNO3 solution to the 5th test tube. You can dispose of all the solutions directly into the sink because they are very dilute. Remember to wash all the glassware and put them away carefully.